Episode 2782, The Power of Mistakes.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. Today is a brand new day, a brand new week. It's time for you to go after what God has laid on your heart. But sometimes we can get caught up in all the rigmarole of what we aren't doing right. However, I got something to tell you, the power of mistakes. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you aren't even had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, most of us cringe at the thought of making mistakes. But what if the power of mistakes could actually increase your success? Fail faster to achieve quicker. As you and I both know, everyone makes mistakes. You can attempt to deny that fact, but if you're a human, then you most definitely have to answer with a resounding, yes, I make mistakes. Okay, those last three words, you say it really quietly so nobody can hear you, especially your husband. Okay, shh, that too's for another episode. But ownership is half the battle, right? Honestly, I mean, come on, let's be real about life. You've been told by mentors, coaches, teachers, and even your parents that nothing is perfect, and that includes you and me. However, if we're being honest, and we're going to be, no one wants to own the mistakes that they know were made, because who wants to be wrong? Just think about your spouse. But remember, that too is for another episode. Even though you don't want to own your mistakes, how can you deal with them in a manner that serves your success in the making? Well, if you want to go farther in life, you have to get comfortable with making mistakes and be willing to bounce back from your mistakes. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Bounce back from your mistakes. Huh, easier said than done, isn't it? I know. Think about the last mistake you made. Oh, wait, maybe it just happened this morning. You're getting up, trying to get ready, the kid's off to school, maybe you haven't started school yet, but you're in preparation for something happening big on a Monday morning, because you know what? This is the Monday, the pre-Monday, I should say, before Labor Day. Yes, I know you're already counting down that you have a three-day weekend coming up. I know where your mind's going, but get your mind back over here. We got to talk about your mistakes. Nobody wants to, but we're talking about them today. How you package your mistakes in your mind matters. Think about that for a moment. How you put it all together, how you see your mistakes, how you package your mistakes in your mind matters. Now, you can choose to beat yourself up over stuff you didn't have complete control over, or you can choose to accept the consequences that happened because of your decision. Either way, there were mistakes. But one way is definitely more forgiving and pushes you forward, whereas the other sets you back. Yes, that thinking. Are you forward thinking or are you backward thinking? What is it? How do you look at your mistakes? How did you look at the one that you already made today, or maybe you've already made 20? Who's keeping track? Right? It's not about keeping track and keeping score of how bad you failed. It's fail faster to achieve quicker. So how do you bounce back from your mistakes? Number one, you got to recognize a mistake first. What went wrong? What happened? Right? If you don't know the mistake, then most likely you're going to make it again because you don't even recognize it. Which leads me to number two. Once when you recognize the mistake, you got to call out the mistake as you see it. How could you have done things differently? What would it look like if you made this decision versus that decision? Play it out in your head. Now, this takes time. Some mistakes are more serious than others. Maybe you bought the wrong house. Okay, that's a definite oopsie. Versus, well, maybe I shouldn't fix that for dinner next time. It wasn't a big hit for the family. It's not necessarily a mistake. I mean, it is because half the people didn't eat it. But you see what I'm getting at? Some mistakes are a lot more critical than others. Dinner versus buying the wrong house, okay? But we have to look at the mistakes as it is. Look at it from a factual point of view. Don't attach your emotions and your feelings. It's easy to do that. We all do it. So you have to look and be realistic and say, okay, this is where I'm at. These are the facts of what I see. Call it out as you see it. I didn't say call out your feelings. Yes, there are times in your mistake makings that you gotta let your feelings come. That's part of being human, right? You can be mad at yourself. You can be mad at someone else. However, how you react in your madness, that's the key there. But that too is for another episode. Wow, we have a lot of episodes here to write, don't we? So recognize a mistake, call out the mistake as you see it. Number three, find the humor in the mistake. Oh yes, as bad as it seemed in the moment, there are still giggles to be had. You gotta laugh at life. If you don't find the humor, well, guess what? Life's gonna get the best of you. You might as well just dig a hole, put your head in it, and be done. Seriously, you've got to find ways to get over the hump and the hurdle of your mistakes, because they're gonna happen. And some, as you move on and you mature and you gain more wisdom, sitting there being frustrated all over everything that has gone wrong doesn't serve you. And it doesn't serve the ones you love, or serving your clients, your customers, whoever you are caring for in the moment. It doesn't serve anybody. So you got to find the humor in the mistake. Number four, celebrate the lesson learned. Not all mistakes are equal, but all mistakes teach a lesson. So celebrate those. That mistake already that we talked about, What lesson did you learn from that? You pressed the snooze button 5 times. Maybe you should get up when you set your alarm, or set your alarm when you want to get up. So if you don't want to get up 10 minutes after your alarm, then why are you setting your alarm for 5:30 if you know you're not going to get up till 5:40? That's ridiculous. Just let your body sleep till 5:40. Set your alarm at 5:40. Don't set it at 5:30. I know it seems like, oh my gosh, mind blown. But if you're always hitting snooze, then change your alarm. Now, if you need to get up earlier, then go to bed earlier. Right? I mean, there's lots of different ways to look at it. But you've got to find that humor. And then once when you have that, and you're like, okay, well, I know this didn't work, then you can celebrate that lesson learned. And when that lesson is, yeah, me pushing snooze every single time, it's just making me run late. And the later I run, the more frustrated I get. And then the more I yell at the kids, and then the more you see the ripple effect here? So celebrate the lesson learned, right? You already named the fact, you found the giggles, and now you're like, okay, I got this. I see what it is. Fabulous. So I'm changing my alarm clock. And then finally, number five, take aim on your next step. It's time to focus on what comes next. You don't dwell on your mistakes. You don't get caught up in all the stuff that's just gonna pull you down, right? If you do, go dig that hole, put your head in it. Seriously, what is it for you? Why do you beat yourself up over a mistake or mistakes? Now, I will say this. Sometimes there are patterns to our mistakes. You then, if you see that and you can catch it, that's why it's important to call out your mistake as you see it. If you begin to see patterns, then that's a good indication that maybe there's a weakness in this area, whatever it is. Maybe there's a weakness in time management. There could be a weakness in leadership. There could be a weakness in your interest in what you're doing in that area. I don't know, but there's a pattern. Find that pattern. And then you can work on that specific habit or routine or skill that you need to overcome that. But sometimes, most of the time, honestly, we're just living life and we make mistakes. We don't think through things. We do things too fast. Maybe we don't do it fast enough. And what happens is there's a mistake. So when that all happens, because it does, you've probably already had 10 mistakes, take aim on your next step. Because you've got to keep moving forward. Remember, one step at a time leads to your miles of greatness. You got to fail faster to achieve quicker. And in that means what? you got to get back up on that horse and keep going again. And when you fail again, you make that mistake. Oh, all right, let's look at this. I made a mistake. All right. Well, you know, it was this, and this is what I did. Well, it wasn't that funny. At least it led me down this. So let me ask you, what has been your favorite mistake? Ooh, a different question. I should have a favorite mistake? Yeah, maybe you should. I'm going to throw this one out there. And I know already you're going to want to send me an email, or some of you will. Please don't. Just know I'm coming from, you know, my heart here when I say this. But, you know, what has been your favorite mistake? Those who have gotten a divorce, but they've had children with the person they got the divorce from. Guess what? Yeah, that may be your favorite mistake, because that mistake gave you your children. So it totally takes a different look on, well, my marriage failed. Well, yeah, it did kind of, but not exactly, because you have a child or two or three. So what has been your favorite mistake? This gives you a chance, again, to look back so you can move forward. It's that space, and we all need that. But it's not getting stuck looking back, right? You see it, you own it, you move forward. Woohoo! Done. Right? And if it is along the serious thing, because I said, you know, understand my heart and where I'm coming from, let's look at from the divorce perspective. Statistically, you know, more than 50% of marriages fail and they end in divorce. It just is what it is. And now that statistic might be changing a little bit, because guess what? We have a lot of people that are not marrying. They're just living together. So there's a lot of failed relationships, committed relationships, not by marriage, but committed relationships. And they fail too. So regardless if it's a marriage fail or a committed relationship fail, right? We have to look and understand, okay, yeah, that didn't work. And what didn't work about it? And say, okay, I got this. I understood the position that I played, the role that I played in the mistake that happened. But then I also can look at it and say, you know what? I don't need to take for granted the lessons learned. I can gather all of those and say, yeah, I learned this and this and this and this. And that allows me now to look at my relationships differently. It helps me respond differently in various situations. But in all of this, remember, when you get past the shock of your mistake, that shock of the divorce, always remember to celebrate. And not because you're not married, but celebrate that this is what I've learned, and this is where I was and where I'm going. And in all of that, your presence matters. Making mistakes is not easy. Well, actually, that's a lie. Making mistakes are really easy. We could do it all the time. But taking our mistakes and acknowledging and learning from them so we don't do it, that reflection, that's a commitment in itself. And a lot of people are not willing to do that. So if you are willing to take that on, you're already leaps and bounds ahead of everybody else. And no, it's not about comparison. But yes, there are times that we need a little pat on our back saying, you know what? I am going the extra mile for my life. This is what I need for me. Mistakes are blessings in disguise. Choose to see what you have learned in the absence of your knowledge. What do you need to see differently today with your mistakes? You know the ones I'm talking about, maybe the more serious ones. Maybe you are divorced. Maybe you haven't overcome that hurdle. Maybe it's arguments that you have with your spouse. Maybe it's not landing the career that you really wanted, and you're just kind of, I don't know, going back and forth. You feel like it's a ping pong life right now with your career. This interest, that interest, you're kind of dabbling here and dabbling there. Nothing really sticks. What can you see in your life right now that you need to deal with? You need to own. You need to acquire the feelings and the maturity to overcome. Because I promise you, there are power in mistakes. But you have to be willing to do the work to get there. and to understand it. And in the power of mistakes, there's healing. Sometimes there's grieving. It just depends on what you're going through. But I want to encourage you today to make room to see the power of your mistakes and say, you know what? It's not just about, oh, it's my fault and owning it that way. There's so much more. So look beyond your mistake. Master today to impact tomorrow. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.